Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun project. So let's get cracking. Good day, friends. I had a user ask about creating a keychain that was flush instead of raised up. Friends, I've done some experimenting. Let me show you what I've got. First, I have brought out a cube, and then to keep these awesome rounded edges, I simply type in the numbers. If you look quick, I've got 5, 10, 20, 35, and 3 for the height. So watch as these snap in. 5 is the radius, kept the 10, kept the 20 for the length, and went to 35, and then changed the height to 3. Now, real quickly, let me show you the other way to do this. If you put that same 5, of course, that stays awesome, but if you stretch it to the distance you want, like 35, check out how it breaks the radius. So I'm just showing you why it can be handy to type the numbers. Second, today I'm using basic text. If we cruise this on top, you can add your word. I'm going to just put yo this time. I scaled this to the size I wanted, and then I only wanted it to be raised up 1 millimeter above. Simple. You could also check out these few fonts that are added. Also, if you go up here to search and type text, there are a few other options you can play with, but generally the ones built into Tinkercad are pretty minimalistic. I've got a lot of tutorials that show how to use SVGs. I will make sure those are linked up above. As I mentioned earlier, though, this project is simply going to be about creating this flush. Remember, it was 1 millimeter high. I've got the nudge set to 1, so I can simply do control down to sink that in. I do want to cut a hole for a keychain. I'm going to bring out a cylinder that is a hole, maximize the sides. Let's do shift squeeze, and I want to type the number 5. That is the typical hole I put for a keychain. Do L for a line. I want the red one to be the boss, and I want it to go to the top and left corner. Now if we use our nudge, that's 1 millimeter in, 1 millimeter down, and then I'm going to switch to a 0.5 millimeter nudge to get it a little closer to exactly where I want, but still leaving a gap between the words that we're printing. I'm going to select those two and do Control G, and we're ready to send it to the printer. Now we're going to still export them separate. So here comes export 1. This is the base. I'm going to call this one flat keychain bottom. And then I'm going to click only on the text. And we're going to export it as well. Still as an STL. And this will be flat keychain text. And now we can move to our slicer. Real quickly, I've got the P1S 0.4 nozzle. These are the two colors I have got loaded. Let's add our shapes. Now we're going to add both of them together. So I'm just selecting the two, clicking OK, and I'm going to load them as a single object, multiple parts. Now yesterday, I came over here and I clicked and I switched the color. Today we're going to use the awesome color painting. So as I zoom in on this, I've clicked color paint and I want to switch out to the fill option and I'm going to fill with orange. And let's move over to where that H is. So right here, I'm in the H area. Notice I missed by a little bit, so I'm going to do Control Z. Let's try that again. Now I got the H. Let's come over here and get the I and dot the I. Now it does not look totally filled because it's covered up, but watch this. If we move on to the slice plate, boom, you can see that we've got all of our parts painted. As we move the slider down, you can see how much of the keychain prints before it actually starts the colors, which should make it a little quicker as this print goes on. Bouncing back to global quick, I'm going to switch out here to others, and this time I'm going to leave the prime tower on because I don't want the colors to mix as they are switching. And with all that double checked, friends, we can simply hit print plate. Notice we should have a finished print in a little less than 22 minutes. As you get started, notice the device menu has popped up, and if we hit play, we'll be able to see the action on our 3D printer. Here I'm going to give you a little, here is a little peek inside the machine. You can see right now we are printing green. I will let you know that my family does complain about the noise of this printer. Even enclosed, it is not the favorite printer in the stable. And check it out right there, it is cleaning the nozzle, and we're about to go through a color swap. If you've never seen this before, that is the filament being retracted. And note the printer has to do this every time it swaps colors during a layer, so it does add some time to your print. And then now it is going to switch to the other filament, and it is being readied for use. And a little more than 20 minutes later, we have got a keychain. How cool is that? Of course, as I wrap up, I want to say thanks again to Craig for the question, and of course, Michael and Brad for suggesting I try out the sweet paint feature in Bambu Studio. Friends, as I wrap up, I just want to remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got a tab dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of awesome categories. And then below that, you can find my day one favorites and also useful starters. And then finally, the Tinkercad essentials. Friends, also at the bottom corner, I want to share the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Lastly, friends, don't forget the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL Mod Tech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL Mod Tech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.